Welcome back. Back with another banger. It's the React Files, where we react
to the creepiest, craziest, scariest TikToks you should watch alone.
I hope you're having a good night. And if you haven't already, please take a second just to hit that like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, just to make sure the algorithm knows what's up. So what are we gonna do, y'all? That's right, run these numbers up. Already, let's get straight to it.
There's a theory that Mars was the original planet that humans were from.
Okay.
And then something happened that we all had to fly to another planet and live on. So there used to be like civilization that lived on Mars.
But now it's all dried up, right?
Now it's all dried up. Now back this. Uh-huh. On Mars, there's an element on the periodic table called xenon. Now, xenon on Earth is only found, this is crazy, is only found after a nuclear explosion.
No. What the hell?
Yeah. So, theory, and it goes hand in hand now. What if on Mars there was a nuclear warfare, destroyed the whole planet, but people were able to escape just in time, landed on Earth, and they had to restart from nothing?
So we are the aliens.
We're the aliens.
What the hell? Nah, that's kind of weird. But that makes sense also.
Because that's how low-key the Earth would end up looking like if we did have a
nuclear destruction. If something happened like that,
What do you think about that theory? That's actually a more entertaining one I haven't heard in a while. We're from Mars.
Okay, so the dark web itself isn't a marketplace, like what you're thinking. All right, so the black market or whatever you want to call it, once you're connected to the dark web, Tor, the onion router, what I was explaining before, you still need to know where to go to visit these horrible websites. And they're like, you know, imagine a very long string of letters and numbers, and the website, instead of .com, it'd be .onion. You can't visit those websites in a regular browser. You have to do that while you're connected to the onion router, which you could download at the Tor, T-O-R's website. And then you could go to a thing called like the hidden wiki. And the hidden wiki will show you all different categories of these websites with a link to them. And there's marketplaces, there's horrible things on there, like you said, for kids. And even like murder for hire, there's counterfeit money, there's fake IDs. You know, there are all kinds of different websites that do horrible things.
Dark web killer.
The video is currently the strangest ever posted on the dark web. It was posted anonymously, so it's impossible to get any more information. It's been the talk of the town, showing supernatural events. But a detail at the end calls everything into question.
Thank you.
I don't know what the half the shit that was. I don't know, that shit was just weird and bizarre. But I guess that's what you really find on the dark net. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing normal. It's all crazy. Have any of y'all experimented with the dark net? Deep web? However you may call it. You know, the land of the back rooms and shit. Let me know in the comments down below.
Ordering an iPhone from the dark web. Let's open it up. Okay, so it's actually an iPhone, and it works. What is this code? What does it mean? It's completely empty apart from some photos. Creepy photos. I think I made a mistake ordering this. I don't want this sketchy iPhone. Creepy ghost iPhone.
Yeah, that was kind of creepy. You would think the dude would delete all the pictures. But you know what was crazy? Those coordinates on the home screen. Have you ever seen that on your phone before? Some coordinates on your home screen? I haven't. Let me know in the comments down below. I gotta call Cap though. That looked like it was some movie shit on Netflix or Tubi. Let me know if you've seen it before. Let me know in the comments down below.
This guy tried to hire a hitman on the dark web and it backfired. In 2015, 31-year-old John Musbach was talking to a minor over the internet. Specifically, he was exchanging photos and videos with a 13-year-old boy. The victim's parents found out and reported him to police, but the victim warned John that the police were coming. John was arrested on CP charges, but while the case was pending, he went on the dark web. He thought that if there wasn't a victim to testify, that maybe the case would be dropped. John paid $20,000 worth of Bitcoin to a random person on a random hitman website. When the victim wasn't killed, John asked for a refund, and that's when the admin said, "Actually, this is a scam, and if you don't give us $10,000, we're gonna turn you into police." John was sentenced the following year for the charges related to the child. He only got a 2-year suspended sentence and a lifetime of supervision. But 2 years later, someone hacked the website and turned all that info over to police. If you want the long detailed version, I just covered this on my podcast.
Damn. Talk about getting scammed. Yeah, that's good for his ass. I wish he would have got more time though. What y'all think in the comments down below? That's what you call karma, ain't it?
It's extremely late right now. I've been trying to sleep, but I can't stop thinking about that egg Chester brought in. I feel like I have to check on it.
Yo, what? Did something come out?
Thank you.
calling cap on that one. Think it was some good acting, though.
Need videos, die verstörend sind.
Findet aber stattdessen diese ausgesprochen gruselige dämonische Puppe. Und schaut mal genau hin auf die Augen der dämonischen Puppe. Die Augen scheinen das Licht auf eine besondere Art und Weise zu reflektieren.
That doll looked like a certain political figure from the East, with horns on its head. It was pretty creepy. I don't know why he was wearing a mask. I don't know. What do you think? Let me know in the comments down below.
That is a video that was supposedly taken off the dark web. You know, I've always wondered, what is the dark web? So from my research, it says that the dark web is a part of the internet that is not indexed by search engines. Given its anonymous nature, the dark web is also used for buying and selling illegal drugs, weapons, passwords, and even stolen identities. It gets worse. It gets worse, like trading and selling people for weird things. Have you ever like seen an influencer talk about how much they bought a girlfriend or a clown or a alien from off the dark web? A lot of people think that this might be a joke sometime, but it's actually real. Things that people fail to understand about the dark web sometimes is that it was actually made by the US government. You should not be afraid to go on the dark web because it's not illegal to go on the dark web. However, it is illegal to purchase things on the dark web, trade things, or to get any type of illegal information. There's even rumors that some of the challenges I do is from the dark web. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments.
Well, that's something new. I didn't know the government created it. So like you said, it's not illegal to go on, but it's illegal to trade, sell, or buy. So guys, be careful. If you guys do go on it, just giving a heads up.
Why does the US government have $5 billion worth of Bitcoin? That's over 200,000 Bitcoin, and most of it comes from cyber criminals and dark web marketplaces. And these are the three largest seizures since 2020. First up, we have James Zhang of 51,000 Bitcoin. He was able to hack the Silk Road marketplace over a decade ago. Then there's the Bitcoin the Fed seized from Silk Road. That was 69,000 Bitcoin. And if you didn't know, Silk Road was the dark web marketplace where you could buy anything from assassins to drugs. And the largest seizure was the Bitfinex hack. That was 94,000 Bitcoin. This was stolen by a married couple who later got caught, but they were later found by authorities with hollowed out books with burner phones inside. You add it all up, that's over $5 billion worth of Bitcoin. What do you think the government should do with it?
It happened again.
Yeah, feet don't fail me now. Look like Buddy got caught in a bad spot.
This guy pretty much lives in the back rooms. Now this video is titled, Just Got Home from a Long Day, Good Night Y'all. And good night is right, cause this boy is living in the back rooms and there's no doubt about that. First of all, when he opens this first door, I'm thinking, this is sus as hell. But it only gets worse from here. Now I'm assuming he's living in an abandoned school or an abandoned apartment complex or something. There's no lights to be turned on. This fool's basically living in Freddy Krueger's house. They've literally made horror movies in places like this. And just the sound of the doors when they open is not giving me a warm feeling. Imagine you met a guy at a bar and he brings you back to this place. I can't imagine they would get through the first door, let alone the second door. Feeling. Now when he finally gets to his room, you gotta just rate his setup. Here it is, right here. This is his bedroom. Okay, he's got a little air conditioning unit, and there we have it. Now that's the pad of a bachelor.
Like, buddy was probably squatting out at an office space that's been abandoned for a few years. Well, at least he had a tablet. Calling cap on that. It was a good edit. I like the idea. What you think? You think that was real? I doubt it.
If you ever come in contact with a hole like this inside your home, it's most likely a trap or something that you need to avoid at all costs. This is a portal directly into the back rooms, and waiting to welcome you with open arms, an entity spotted in the back already.
And that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed tonight's rabbit hole. Unfortunately, it's come to its end. And if you haven't already, please take a second just to hit that like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, just to make sure the algorithm knows what's up. That's what we're gonna do, y'all. That's right. Run these numbers up. Thanks again. Until next time.